I want to move over now to this, though, and signing A.J. Green. You guys clicked on the video. This was in the main title. Listen, a lot of reports are linking us to A.J. Green. ESPN had a great article predicting one star player to each team, and they predicted A.J. Green to us. And proposed a four-year, $48 million contract for A.J. Green. We know Emmanuel Sanders. He's a free agent. So if Sanders were to walk, Green is one of those free agent wide receivers the 49ers could really go ahead and take a look at. Here's the deal. If Sanders goes, you've got to get a replacement wide receiver. I know we just said Jalen Hurts going to play, but you need another big hitter on the outside. And whether it's A.J. Green, Robbie Anderson, Amari Cooper technically will be a free agent, although Dallas probably will re-sign him. There are a lot of players you can go and get. Now, the problem with A.J. Green is he didn't play last year. He had a bunch of injuries. 2018, he only played in 9 games, and you see the stats on your screen right now, 46 catches, 694 yards, and 6 touchdowns. But many believe now that he's 100% healthy, and he is healthy, he should be good to go. Even at 32 years old, he can still be the dominant wide receiver that he was for a long time there in Cincinnati. We forget that at his peak and when he was healthy, he was right up there with DeAndre Hopkins and up there with Julio Jones. This is an elite 6'4", 210-pound wide receiver that can get the job done, both just as a possession receiver and also as a deep threat. To me, there are a lot of younger wide receivers in free agency. Robbie Anderson, he's 29 years old, but A.J. Green is going to be cheap because he is old and he's coming off of injuries. If you can get A.J. Green for less than like $10 million a year, I know it's possible, but let's say $10 to $11 to $12 million a year for 3 years, and he stays healthy, an absolute steal. Green on the outside, and then you throw in Debo and Jalen Hurts, it's a really good receiving core. Pick the wide receiver, though. Type G in the comment section if you want A.J. Green. Type S if you want Emmanuel Sanders, because where our cap space looks, you can't get both. So if you re-sign Sanders, no A.J. Green. If you get A.J. Green, then there is no re-signing Sanders. So let me know what you guys think in the comment section. G for A.J. Green, S for Emmanuel Sanders. All right, Niner betting is over, right? You can't bet on any Niner games until, you know, the beginning of next season. But NBA, college basketball, heck, NASCAR starts up this weekend. You guys want to bet on sports, use our friends BetDSI. 120% deposit bonus whenever you first sign up. Promo code is 49ers. Even though you're not betting on the Niners, you still use the promo code 49ers. So you put down 100 bucks, it turns into 220 bucks for you guys to go ahead and bet your brains out, which is a good time to do it because, again, sometimes you bet with your heart because you like the Niners. You can bet with your head, though, now because the Niners are not a team you can bet on and maybe win some more money overall. Well, as we said, you bet on the Niners this past year, you probably won a lot of money. Okay, let's keep going here. I wanted to show you guys my three biggest needs for the 49ers this offseason: offensive line, wide receiver, and secondary. Now, I don't think it's in that order. You can kind of put one above the other. It doesn't matter where you put them. But these are the three biggest ones because, again, Joe Staley aging. He might not even come back this year, even though he is signed, might retire. A wide receiver, we talked about Emmanuel Sanders, you lose him. You're going to need to go ahead and get somebody to help out with Debo Samuel. And secondary is still important if you let Jimmie Ward go, who's your other free agent. So, as you see here, your three biggest notable free agents are Arik Armstead, Emmanuel Sanders, and Jimmie Ward. If all of them leave, you got to find replacements, especially for Sanders and Ward. Armstead, the D-line would still be okay. It wouldn't be as elite, but it would still be okay. Sanders and Jimmie Ward, though, if you let them go, as you see here, your wide receiver group without Emmanuel Sanders is not that good. Like, this group right here is not getting you to a Super Bowl. I don't care how good the defense is. I don't care how good the running game is. Unless Jimmy Garoppolo takes that next step to, like, young Carson Wentz, young Patrick Mahomes-type levels, this is not going to get it done. You've got to go out and get another wide receiver. And the D-line, though, is different. You see, you still have Dee Ford. You still have Buckner. DJ Jones will be healthy. Nick Bosa. This can still win you football games without Arik Armstead. Now, it's better with Armstead. We all understand that. But this overall is going to be okay if you're unable to re-sign Arik Armstead. So, let me know. Comment section. What is the biggest 49er need this offseason? Is it wide receiver? Is it O-line? Is it D-line? Is it secondary? Is it none of the above? Go ahead and comment in the comment section down below. Aaron says, Jimmy did a great job in my eyes. Someone else says, Debo is the GOAT. Yeah, that's true, but it would still be nice to have another wide receiver going forward. Biggest offseason need? Let me know in the comment section down below. And look at this. We are literally less than 1,000 subscribers away from 15,000 subs. We're killing it. We're one of the fastest growing 49er channels here on YouTube. So if you're not subscribed to the 49er Report, help a brother out. Big red subscribe button down below. Click the red subscribe button. That way we can get to 15,000. We are so close. Should have this by next week, but maybe we can go a little bit quicker if you guys subscribe a little bit quicker overall.